Hello, everybody, and welcome to Jointly Speaking. This is Barbara, your host. Well, as you know, it's December, and it's time for the holidays. So what I would like to do this year is play a little music for you and get you in the mood and hope you have a wonderful, wonderful holiday. And just remember, 2021 is around the corner, and things will be looking a lot better in that year. So have a wonderful holiday, and I'll see you in January. And thank you very much.
City sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in a holiday style. In the air, there's a feeling of love. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile, and on every street corner you hear silver bells. Silver bells, it's Christmas time in the city. Ring a ling, hear them ring. Soon it will be Christmas Day. Strings of streetlights, even spotlights, blink a bright red and green. As the shoppers run home with their treasures, hear the snow crunch, see the hills bunch. This is Santa's big scene, and above all the bustle you hear. Silver bells, silver bells, it's Christmas time.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Barbara, and I'm hosting Jointly Speaking, the talk show. And today we're doing something very different. I've never had an audience before, but we have a lovely audience from Whitney Place Assisted Living, and we're going to be singing and wishing people Merry Christmas, and I hope you will enjoy it and take time to listen and pass it on to other people as well. So what we'd like to do first is get someone to wish Merry Christmas. So who would like to start out? And they're all raising their hand, folks. I want you to know that. Okay, I will do the first one.
Okay, I'd like to wish Patty and Lorette in Oregon a very Merry Christmas. I love you all. A.B. Okay, now let's go up to somebody else.
I'd like to wish all the Grahams and all the adopted Grahams a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and try to remember what you were taught when you were living with us in the teen haven. Remember the Bible in one hand, the rod in the other. So keep living that way and meet all your challenges with the Bible first. And if that doesn't work, and it will if you have enough faith, then try the rod. That's what kept all you kids in line the years that you lived with me. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Judy. I want to wish my daughter, who is sleeping right now, her name is Sharon, and she lives in Queensland, Australia. So I wish them a very happy Christmas, my whole family that's out there.
Thank you. Hi, this is Linda Liu. A big shout out to everyone in Laytonville, California, particularly Eli, Chloe, and Kylie. Have a great holiday, everybody.
Yeah, when I was a kid, there was a Jordan Marsh in Boston, and they used to have Santa Claus there. They used to have the Enchanted Village. And I think today a lot of some of the malls have something like that.
Oh,
Can I interrupt you for a minute?
You just did, sure.
Okay, I just I'm very good at this. No, I want you all to meet Ed O'Coin. He is our entertainer for today. And I just want you to know how much I appreciate your coming here and doing this. We truly, truly love having you. So
I'm having fun, and everybody's having fun, so it's win-win all the way around.
Okay.
So it's my pleasure.
Well, thank you very much. And now we're going to do Frosty the Snowman.
Okay. Here we go.
Frosty the Snowman was a jolly nice soul, with a corn cob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal. Frosty the Snowman is a fairy tale, they say. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day. There must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found. For when they put it on his head, he began to dance around. Oh, Frosty the Snowman was alive as he could be. And the children say he could laugh and play just the same as you and me. Frosty the Snowman, the sun was hot that day, so he said, let's run and we'll have some fun now before I melt away. Down to the village with the broomstick in his hand, running here and there all around the square, saying, catch me if you can. He led them down the streets of town, right to the traffic cop, and he only paused a moment when he heard a mama's cry. Frosty the Snowman had to hurry on his way, but he waved goodbye, saying, don't you cry, I'll be back again someday. But he waved goodbye, saying, don't you cry, I'll be back again someday.
Thank you. Thank you. I have to tell you, snowmen are my favorite things. I love snowmen. You'll see me with snowmen everywhere. So I love that particular song. How about, Linda, can we get some more residents to wish Merry Christmas to their families? Our relatives, the people they owe money to?
That would be most of them.
That would be different.
So my name is Ed. So I want to wish my brother, Paul, and his wife, Fedna, in Florida, a very Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Thank you, Ed, for doing that.
Hi, this is Mary, and I want to wish my good friends, all of my good friends, a very Merry Christmas, and ask them to pray for me, because my other friends, Visa, Amazon Prime, they're all out chasing me, and it's only because I thought of all of you. So I wish you all a very, very Merry Christmas.
God bless you, Mary.
Good morning. My name is Gail. I'm from Worcester, but not originally. I'm a Midwesterner, Chicago. I want to wish a very Merry Christmas to my children, April in Florida, and her new baby, Madison, Brett and his girlfriend, Adriana, Blair, my daughter, and her boyfriend, Brian, Sherry, my sister in Oxford, England, Kelly, my sister in Paris, France, Lanny and Bob, my sister and brother-in-law in Chicago, and Al and Kathy, my brother and his girlfriend in Wisconsin. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
I wish I had as many relatives as she does all along, I'm afraid. Who else?
This is all from Giggy. My grandchildren call me Giggy, so the whole family does too, I guess. So this is a Merry Christmas to all my friends in Shrewsbury and all around the towns here. My five children, and they're significant others, my great-grandchildren, and my great-great-grandchildren. Thank you so much.
I'm trying to think of who I can.
Everybody, you can say, and Merry Christmas to the world.
Merry Christmas to the world, and to my family, and my grandchildren, my son and daughter-in-law, and the whole bit.
And your name?
What?
What's your name, so they know who's saying it?
Helen.
That was from Helen.
Hi, I want to say hello to all the Peters of the world and their families. I wish them a Merry Christmas, and I hope we can see each other soon.
I have a large family, and I hope that they all enjoy their Christmas, and my grandchildren, my children, and God bless to each one of them.
Everybody join in. Some more family, so I'm just going to periodically announce the family as we go. So there's David, Linda, and Rusty. They're all my nieces and nephews, and they all live in Colorado. So I'd like to wish you a very Merry Christmas. I love you all. AB. That's what they call me, AB. So we go with that. All right, who else is going to do a name? Come on. How about Charlie up in the back? Come on, Charlie, you know somebody. Come on. I know you do.
I want to wish my oldest daughter, Angela, and her husband, Pete, and my two granddaughters, Sydney and Madison, a very Merry New Year and Christmas. And my daughter, and they're from Framingham, and my other daughter lives in Worcester, and she is always busy. And I wish her a happy Christmas, too. Thank you.
Very nice, Charlie. Very nice.
I'd like to give a shout-out to Warren, New Jersey, to Mom G. I hope that you're listening. It's been a rough 3 weeks. Love you very much.
Well, happy Christmas to everybody connected with us. Thank you.
Very nice.
You guys.
Hello, I would like to send some Christmas greetings to my Aunt Pat, who lives in the Riverside, California area, and also to my Aunt Jane, who lives in Pennsylvania.
On a more serious vein from my last response, I want to wish the California Pines, the New Hampshire Pines, and the Massachusetts Pines a very, very Merry Christmas, and I urge them to remember that this is a special day, the day that Jesus was born. Merry Christmas to all of you.
How about a shout out to my brother Lance and his new wife Kim and their two children in Linden, New Jersey. Merry Christmas. You know I love you.
Hi, it's Gail again. I want to greet all of my fellow musicians, the New England Ringers, and the First Handbells of First Baptist Church, Worcester. Thank you.
It's fantastic.
So the song is Let It Snow, next on your list, right? Whoops, false start. That's okay, I'm good. Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Doesn't show signs of stopping, but I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm. But if you really can hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. Well, the fire is slowly dying, and I hear we're still goodbye. As long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Let it snow, let it snow.
Very good, hey. Hey, we're doing okay. I thought I'd like to do something a little bit different right now, and not to scare all of you either. But how about some memories of Christmas? Does anyone have memories of a nice Christmas that they had, or a big Christmas, or something special? Anybody want to talk about it? Oh, they're all looking at me like they're scared to death. It's easy. Nobody can see us. Just
what
say.
What about some traditions, maybe?
Or traditions,
you
yeah.
used to follow that were
something
meaningful
like that.
To you growing up.
Yeah, that's a good idea, Ed. How about a tradition? Something you did growing up with your parents, or?
So I have one.
Oh.
Hold on. Let me get this to you.
Yeah. Patient. So this is Ed. I'm of Canadian descent. My grandparents were all from Nova Scotia, New Brunswick side of Canada. And every Christmas, we would have this meat pie, which was pork with onions and summer savory. And then it was baked within like a bread dough. And it was called pâté. I don't even know how to spell that. I just learned how to say it. But Christmas wasn't Christmas until you woke up Christmas morning and the pâté was in the oven. And it has a unique smell, and that just permeated the kitchen. Pâté and coffee is just, it's Christmas. So that's what Christmas is when I was growing up. And I grew up in Waltham, which has a very, very high French-Canadian population.
So are you still making the pâté today?
No. Because I don't know how, but my mother's brother is having a Christmas party on December 28th, and that's the intent of the party. We're all going up. And we're bringing all kinds of stuff, and we're all going to make the pork pie for each other. So stuff to take home. So we're looking forward to that. So that'll be fun. Yeah.
Yeah, the tradition is at Christmas time, and this is a lot of work. We had to make, they're called struvelies. They're little round balls with honey on them. And you had to make the dough, let it rise. And this was a lot of work. And then you'd take a piece, maybe the size of a ruler, and you'd cut it in small pieces, and you'd make it into a little ball, like the size of a marble. And then you lay them, and then you build it up to the top. And then you put honey on them, and then you put little candies on them. They were delicious, but there was a lot of work, but it was worth it. You know, one year we didn't have time to make it, so we actually bought them. But they're not the same. When you bite into it, it's like all air. Yeah. Nothing like homemade.
Gail, again, two of my children are born very close to Christmas. And I was the best hostess for giving birthday parties. We had a lot of fun. Sometimes we combined birthday parties, but one was given, for example, at the YMCA as a splash party. I didn't realize I had to invite all the parents too for this. And another was given on a train, where we rented a whole car in the train and did our activities at those tables. Another tradition was our Advent calendar. I made my own for the kids. Great big box, like you would see in a CVS store, with pockets, big box pockets, 24 pockets. The children would cover the white sheet of paper with their own decorations. And then each day, day one through day 24, they would get to cut open the box and see what was inside for them. Thank you.
Wow, that's great.
Hi. This wasn't my tradition, but it was one that I heard about just yesterday, and it was one that I thought was positively beautiful. And it's this family, of many adult children now, and grandchildren, all that. And it came so that there were too many people to buy presents for. Therefore, they tried, to pick one out of the pile and all that. They picked all kinds of things. But to make a long story short, each family decided on a charity. Each one was different. And they put the money that they would spend for presents to the rest of the family, and they donated it to that charity. And they did that for years, and now they have an album of all their Christmas gifts and / donations that have been given over the years from the different family members. I thought it was positively beautiful. Yes, and it's too bad that I'm past that time to do that now. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Mary.
No, yeah, my father was one of 10. So the holidays, we did not eat together. There were too many of us. But we used to go visit one another at Easter time, because we all lived in the same area, just to wish everybody a nice holiday, Merry Christmas or a Happy Easter. It was nice to see everybody. That was
My parents always went to midnight mass. And before I was old enough to go, I had to stay home with my other brothers and sisters. And my mom and dad would come home about 1 o'clock from mass and go to bed. We'd all be in my room waiting for them to go to bed. And then we'd get up and scare them to half to death and have to open all our Christmas presents at 1:30 in the morning. They were not happy campers. But you know, my mother told me later in life that she said that was the best memory they ever had was, because we always wait to be sure they got into bed before we called them and said, it's time to get up. So that's my favorite memory of Christmas. It's a good one.
Love that.
Yeah. Anyway, Ed, do you want to try another one?
Sure.
Okay, let's go.
Rocking Around the Christmas Tree.
Ooh.
Remember Brenda Lee? Did you know that she was 13 years old when that song came out? So when you hear the Brenda Lee version of this song,
really?
She was 13 years old at the time.
Wow.
She's like 4'10".
Yeah.
I don't know where she gets that voice from. All right.
Wow.
We're rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party. Mistletoe hung where you can see, every couple tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. You will get a sentiment. Christmas singing, let's be jolly. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, rockin' around the Christmas tree, have a happy holiday. Everyone dancing merrily in a beautiful fashion way. You will get a sentimental feeling when you hear voices singing, let's be jolly. The halls with boughs of holly, rockin' around the Christmas tree, have a happy holiday. Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way. Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way.
That's fantastic. Anybody else got any good memories I want to talk about? Oh, Nancy, good.
About up until last year, I used to do the Giving Tree at St. Anne's Church in Shrewsbury. So we used to have a list of all the children and, you know, what they'd like for Christmas, whatever. And it was just, that was probably one of the special times of the year to see these kids get these gifts, and I used to give out the gifts and everything, so it was great.
This is your 100-year-old aunt wishing you a very Merry Christmas and the best ever coming year. I hope you have a wonderful season, and I hope that you get everything you want from Santa Claus.
Thank you.
My name is Isabel.
Okay. Isabel, do you have any memories of anything of the holidays that you did that you think is growing up? Or, you know?
Well, I can tell you about going out in the woods and chopping down a Christmas tree. Ooh. And dragging it back down to the house and putting it up. And we had branches all over the place, but we had a live tree every year. And decorated it beautifully with different types and different seasons on the tree as much as we could. So, and of course waited for Santa Claus and got very disturbed when we found out who he was.
Did you get a favorite gift? Can you think of a gift you got from Santa that was the best?
Oh, of course, a doll. A doll that had real hair and a very pretty dress, and could say, Mama.
Oh, very good.
Back in those days, that was something new. Back in my day.
You were born, yes, I can believe that.
Well, I never thought I'd be here for 100 years, but here I am, and grateful for every day the good Lord gives me.
Yep. So,
I had a little something lined up in my mind until my friends dropped in unexpectedly, and they were so impressed with the place, I had a hard time trying to get away to come here.
But. Well, every Christmas, my son comes from Texas here at Wintley Place, and my daughter cooks the meal. All the presents come here. All the family comes here. So I wouldn't be alone. We share it all together. Here. Yeah.
Oh, memories from, well, Christmas, obviously. But my grandmother, who was about, was about this high. She was a little tiny Italian woman. But she could cook whatever meal that you wanted. We had, you know, with spaghetti and pasta and meatballs and then she's just a little late, and she's just, if you know, you didn't do it right, it's like, let go, and she did the horse, let go, did something wrong, let go, you know. But she could do, yeah, she was the great, I'm not a big cook person, but I can cook a little bit but nothing like that. I know, but it was just, that's what I thought of her. for the little lady, little Italian lady. Bocca loop is the only word I could think of. Whatever. I know it means something, but I think, I hope so too. Yeah, we're not going on the bad side. No.
Okay. Anybody else run out of songs to sing? So you may not have the words to it.
Yeah, we don't have the words to these songs. The last song we'll do is Silent Night. You have the words for that one. But we have some others here that we'll do. But I think this is one that most everybody knows. I would be shocked if not. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list, checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're away. He knows if you've been down or good. So be good for putting this saint. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Yeah, you can do that one.
How about another one, Ed?
Sure. Last week when we ran out of songs, I think it was the young lady in front row said, Ed, what's your favorite song?
And wow, that was a mistake.
No, actually it wasn't, because I remember that. And so remember back in the 50s, there was a guy named Dave Seville, and he had a novelty act called Alvin and the Chipmunks.
Oh, yes.
Remember that?
Yeah.
And I heard this on the radio the other day, so this is, you know, 50, 60 years later, and they're still playing this. So I think you guys probably remember this. You might not.
Christmas, Christmas time is near. Time for toys and time for cheer. We've been good, but we can't last. Hurry Christmas, hurry fast. On the plane that moves the loop. I want a hoover hoop. We can hardly stand the wait. This Christmas don't be late.
See, they know this one, huh?
On the plane that moves the loop. Me, I want.
Feliz Navidad?
It's been a lot. Oh, yes.
Kacey Musgraves just released an album last year, which is what made me think of this one. Kacey Musgraves is very popular right now in country circles and even crossover. And she released an album, and that song was on it. And so when I heard that, it was like, okay, that's one we got to put on the playlist. Okay. Here's one that we... this song is also, I think, back in the 70s. Jose Feliciano did Feliz Navidad. It's like all the Spanish I know. And I do it phonetically, just to be clear, right? That's it. But here we go. I said, here we go. Fe-
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.
There we go. You guys were all joining in on that one. That was great. Nice job. Well, I don't know if they're quite ready for us.
Yeah. Hey,
we're good for them, but I don't know if they would be as accepting.
They might be surprised.
We could do the Muppet Show.
Yeah. We could. What we lack in skill, we make up in excitement. And enthusiasm. Want to do another?
Yes, I'd love to.
So this one is called God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen.
Oh, yes.
You don't have the words for this, because this is just one of those extras we're tossing in, because it's fun, okay? God rest, whoops, hold on. Small minor adjustment. I was down in the cellar. Okay, that's better. God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. For Jesus Christ our Savior was born upon this day to save us all from Satan's power when we had gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. God, our heavenly Father, a blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same, how that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. For Jesus Christ our Savior was born upon this day to save us all from Satan's power when we had gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Music. I like you. This is good. Good stuff.
Before anything happens and I forget, I want to thank Whitney Place Assisted Living for allowing us to do the radio show here every month. I want to thank Northborough Cable Access TV for helping us do the show, getting it recorded, getting it on the air. Dana, thank you so much. And I want to thank Ed O'Coin for being such a fantastic entertainer and helping us with all of this. I really appreciate it. No, I love this. And as a first experience, I have to tell you, it's wonderful. I've never had so much fun. So we shall get on. And I just want to wish one more person Merry Christmas. And if I forget her, she'll hang me. It's my daughter, Pamela, and she's in Florida. So Merry Christmas, Pam. I love you, Mom. Okay, and what are we going to do next?
Lunch.
Oh, lunch? We got a few minutes. We got...
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. 'Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Donning now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carols, fa la 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 la. Blazing Yule before us, fa la 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 la. Strike the harp and join the chorus, fa la 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 la. Follow me in merry measure, fa la la fa la 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 la. While I tell the Yuletide treasure, fa la 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 la.
Go back.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. 'Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la.
Microphone and grab those two that just walked in. Perfect timing.
Another shout out to the Linden, New Jersey area. I hope that everybody's well and happy. Merry Christmas, everyone. And here is our esteemed leader, Ed.
Hello and Merry Christmas, everybody. Special hello to my boy Daniel out at the University of Southern California and all of his friends in the School of Dramatic Arts. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas to all of you.
Jen, would you like to wish someone a Merry Christmas? Wish someone a Merry Christmas.
Wish somebody.
A Merry Christmas.
My brother.
Okay.
Robert.
Okay.
Merry Christmas to you.
That was from Jen.
Remember back in 1964 when Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer animated special came out, and it's been on TV every year since. They got their money's worth out of that one.
They sure
they
did.
And the snowman was played by Burl Ives, and there was a hit that came out of that TV show, which was called Holly Jolly Christmas.
Yeah.
Right? I think you might remember this. It might sound familiar.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, the mistletoe hung where you somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year. Oh, oh, the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year. Oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
I love those big endings.
You know.
Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen. I got them all written here. That's the only reason I know. I've never been, it's like, you know, 30 days, half November, all that stuff, I can't remember. Anyway, that's a different discussion. But do you recall the most famous reindeer of all? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, you'll go down in history. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, you'll go down in history. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, you'll go down in history.
You have to sing. There are some people that are really afraid of a microphone.
Yeah.
They are. You guys are doing great.
You guys are doing wonderfully.
Wonderful. I'm so happy. Well, we're getting close to the end. But I want to thank you all for coming today. I really do appreciate this. And we've been talking, Ed and I, and we thought we would do maybe another show in the springtime. And do another show, and we haven't figured out what, but if you have any suggestions, please let us know. We'd love to hear from you. And I loved having all of you here today. And I truly want to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
And Ed, would you like to close us out with Silent Night? We thought this would be appropriate.
Yeah. Nice closing song to the last one that you guys have.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heaven. Shepherds quake at the sight, glory streamed from heaven afar, heavenly hosts sing alleluia, Christ the Savior is born.
Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.